My name is Nikki Faye the Wanderer. Full-time traveler. I have been traveling full-time for the past 4 years. So I started traveling full-time because my mother passed away and I just realized life was too short. She passed away at the age of 57 years old. And I was like, you know what? What is the retirement age in the US? Because that was the goal I had set for myself, to travel full-time once I retired. So I figured out the retirement age was 66. So at that rate, my mom would have never made it. So I decided to leave my corporate 9-to-5 and start traveling full time. And I'm telling you, it is the best decision I have ever made. I have not looked back. And let me tell you, things have not always gone the way that I planned. I wrote a book about the fact that I was stuck in the middle of my travels with $2 in the bank account. And I swear, that is a true story. I was stuck in the middle of Ghana with $2 in my bank account. But I made it. So I didn't get frustrated. I didn't call home and say, hey, send some money so I can come back. I just got resourceful and figured out a way to travel with little to no money at all. In my case, it was $2. So I wrote a book about that, but I digress. So I have been traveling for the past 4 years. And I've been really enjoying myself. I've traveled to over 50 countries. And in 4 years, one could travel to far more countries, but I like to slow travel. I like to spend at minimum 3 months in a country just to really enjoy, explore, take in the culture, meet the people, and really like live at the place, you know? And that's been the joy of travel for me, just really being there and immersing myself into the entire culture. So that's the best part for me. Oh, and the food, of course. So as the quarantine hit, I decided to, because I don't have a permanent residence, so I decided to go back to my home base because every maybe year or so, I pick a new home base. And this time it was Kenya. So I decided to come back to Kenya and just wait it out. And you know, who knows when I'll travel again, but I'm so happy to be here because there is so much to do in Kenya, let me tell you. So today, I want to share a little bit of my world here in Kenya with you, because it's more than just the safaris and, you know, kind of the stuff you see in the media in the US about Africa. Like, it's nothing like that. I mean, granted, there is some poverty, there are some bad sides, but I want to show you my life here in Kenya and some of the things that you can do when you come and visit Kenya. So first, I'm a huge foodie. So first, I want to talk about the food. The restaurants are superb. My favorite restaurant here is called About Time. It's a small little kitchen, but beautifully decorated. It has an indoor, outdoor seating, and it's just so beautiful. I love it, and the food is exquisite. And clearly, that's the most important part, right? So the next place I like to go and dine and have a meal, maybe a cocktail, is Carol T. Lounge. Now, Carol T. Lounge is in Gigiri, very close to the U.S. Embassy, by the way. And it's in a market village called Village Market. So it's really beautiful. I mean, when you come to Kenya, you don't expect to see something like Carol T. Lounge, but it is just amazing. Just the view and the ambiance is just something that keeps you coming back for more. Now, a restaurant everyone goes to when they visit here is called The Talisman. Now, everyone goes, but it actually is delicious. So I like to go there every now and again, especially when I'm having guests in town. So The Talisman, oh, beautifully decorated. The food is amazing, which is again the most important piece, right? The food is amazing. My favorite thing there on the menu is the pork belly. Oh, it's honey glazed and it is just everything, let me tell you. All right, so if you're the kind of person who want a little sushi, a little Japanese food in your life, there's a restaurant called Inti that is just, oh, everything. So the sushi there, the food, everything is amazing. If you're a vegetarian, this is where I'd send you, Inti. And oh my gosh, people, it is so beautiful, so beautiful. And the last restaurant, which is on my favorites list, strictly for the ambiance, it's called Seven Seafood. I mean, when I stepped into this place, I said, this could not be the Kenya I've heard about, but it is. So beautiful. I mean, exquisite. One of the most beautifully decorated restaurants I've been to. Okay? And that says something because I've traveled all over. All right. So one of my favorite things to do here in Kenya is Sunday brunch. So I have a crew of friends, expats, non-expats, and we like to go to Honey and Dough. Honey and Dough is a newer restaurant, but the food is so good. The menu, it's kind of like, it reminds me of a Cheesecake Factory because the menu is probably about 6 pages long and everything I've had has been delicious. I love Honey and Dough. And you know, the best thing at Honey and Dough is that's where you can get, what is it, people? What do we like for breakfast? Mimosas. So you can have your mimosas at Honey and Dough anytime, and a plethora of food listings and food choices at Honey and Dough. Just amazing. All right. So after Sunday brunch, the thing I want to do most is go to an event. See some live music. Now, there are a number of hotels in the areas that host live music, live bands. I feel like Kenya does the live band scene better than any other place I've been to. So the first place I went to when I got here, a friend of mine told me to meet up with her friend. She said, meet me at Jay's Bistro. Oh my God, I had so much fun. The music was amazing. They did US covers. They did local music, music from all around the world. You could not tell where you were when you were in this place because the music was so diverse. It was so amazing. Also, there are some amazing hotels here. Tribe Hotel, the Dusit Hotel. You can go there for entertainment as well to meet up with friends. The Tribe Hotel is so beautiful. It's so amazing. It also has a nice bar, but we'll talk about that later. And the Dusit Hotels, I go there to swim, go there to enjoy the spa. And then, more live music, Hemingway's. Oh, Hemingway's has a Sunday brunch with live jazz that is just great. So I love going there. And the last thing on my list, as far as live music, is K1 Clubhouse. Now, this is a place we go to on Sundays. There is a market there. There is food. There are drinks. And there's so many people, so it's so much fun. Oh, and they sing and we dance and just, oh, it's just great because you can just talk to strangers and just have a great time. This was the last thing on my list, but not the least, all right? So, the next thing I like to go to here, rooftop bars. Now, anyone who knows, I'm from LA, I love a good rooftop bar. So here, I'm gonna name my top three rooftop bars. The first one is Sankara Hotel. Oh my God, it is beautiful there. Also, they have live music, great food, and on the rooftop. What more do you need, okay? The next place is the Tambourine Hotel. Yes, it's almost like tambourine. I'm ready to dance already. So you can go there for live music and enjoy the ambiance. And the last place was something I mentioned before very briefly, but it's the Nest at the Tribe Hotel. When I tell you beautiful, oh my God, you have to see it. And then, of course, so any girl like me wants to shop. Shop, shop, shop till you drop. So what some of my favorites are, I mentioned before, Village Market. And oh, it's so beautiful. It's an indoor-outdoor market. They have everything you might need, and it's just beautiful. I believe it's 4 stories. They have a bowling alley. They have a food court, which is not like your normal mall food court for us. I mean, on Friday and Saturday nights, this food court is jumping. You can go to the Oyster Bar. You can go have a burger. You can have a pizza. You can do anything you want. Oh, also, you can go bowling, as I mentioned before, but they also have an event center where you can go and play games. Literally all the games you have ever played in your life will be here. Scrabble, Taboo. ping pong, anything your heart's desire, they have it there. So the Village Market is number one on my list. The Sarah Center, now it's an older establishment, you know, kind of an older mall, but they have renovated the top level and now it is just beautiful. They have a center up there where you can have an event or you can attend the event. They have an amazing food court. One of my favorite restaurants in that food court is called Fonda. We don't have many Mexican restaurants now, but this is one and it is very good. If you need a good margarita, Fonda is the place. All right, so every time I tell my friends I'm in Kenya, they're like, oh my God, you poor thing, are you living in a mud hut? And I'm like, come on people, ignore what you've seen in the media, on the news, we don't live like that. We have some beautiful residential villas. I mean, I am living well, trust me. I'm an American, forget I'm an American, I am me. And everyone who knows me knows I like something nice, something modern, and something beautiful. That's what we have here in Kenya. So don't think we're living in mud huts. We are not, okay? And, okay, one of my favorite things, it's a secret, don't tell anybody, but when I get my hair done, when I wanna get my nails done, when I wanna have a massage, I go to Posh Palace. Yes, I know you can see the pictures right now. Posh Palace is a beautifully decorated spa, and it's like being in a resort. I mean, they have two levels, the normal Posh Palace, and then they have the Posh Diamond. Now that's where I like to hang out because when you're having your manicures and pedicures, you can also have a cocktail. Yes, now that's my kind of place and probably yours too. All right, so I'm gonna wind this up with my favorite vacation spot in Kenya. Now, it's not very popular, but if people actually knew about it, it would be packed all the time. So, my favorite vacation spot and favorite beach here in Kenya is Watamu. When I tell you it's beautiful, the water is so blue and see-through. It is just amazing. And not just the water, the sand is beautiful. And I love the sand that's like really, you know, not very grainy and it's like powder and I just rub it in my hands and just really enjoy. Okay, I love sand. But this place is amazing. Like it's a hidden gem because not too many people have heard of it. Ask someone if they've been to Watamu and they'll tell you no. Now they've been to Diani, but they haven't been to Watamu. Watamu has some of the most beautiful hotels. I mentioned Hemingway's earlier. They also have a Hemingway's in Watamu. Just amazing. It looks like something from any country and any of the most beautiful places you've ever wanted to visit. Bali, where else? Thailand. It definitely rivals those. It is amazing. Like I could stay here forever. Oh, I guess I kind of have, huh? So Watamu is one of my favorite destinations. There, oh my gosh, what is there to do in Watamu? I have taken a boat ride through the mangrove. I have watched the sunset from the boat while I went through the mangrove on the beautiful lakes. I have had crabs on the mangrove right on the water, and I mean delicious crabs at the crab shack. Even more things that you can do in Watamu are you can whale watch. There is whale watching in Watamu. People don't think you can watch whales in Kenya, but you can. There is whale watching and it's so amazing. There's snorkeling. I went on a boat in Watamu and it was a glass bottom boat. Now, I don't do that so much because I can't swim, but here there was a glass bottom boat. The last time I had been on one of those was in Florida because I try to stay off the water, can't swim. Actually, I am learning to swim. But a glass bottom boat, you can go snorkeling, you can go fishing, and then there's a spot called Lover's Island. Oh, it is shaped in a heart, and in the middle is water, and then you can watch the sea from that space with your loved one. If you have one, if not, you can do it by yourself because I went solo. This is one of the most beautiful towns I have ever been to. Not only are there beautiful hotels, but there are also private villas. When I was there, I stayed in a couple of places. There was a private villa that I stayed in for literally pennies on the dollar. Literally, I think I may have spent like $25 a night, and it was a beautiful villa. And they provided breakfast every morning. I mean, amazing experience. If you haven't been to Watamu, you have to go. And I mean, let me tell you about this one thing first. Before we go, there's the Rock and Sea Hotel. I went to this Rock and Sea Hotel. You know those bubble lodges where you can go and you can see, you know, the whole world basically while you're asleep because it's clear and plastic. Oh, it was so amazing. I had such a wonderful time. This resort is set up so well. They have a beautiful area where you can sit on the beach, or you can go to the pool, or you could sit in your lodge. They also have a beautiful rooftop bar there. I mean, amazing, as you can see now. You climb those stairs, and at the very top is a beautiful rooftop bar with 360 degrees where you can see out to the ocean, the beautiful resort. You can just sit there all day just looking out. Oh my gosh. I'm just thinking about it now. I'm ready to go again, okay? But Watamu is a really amazing place. Don't let them fool you and tell you, oh, it's Mombasa, Diana, you have to go to. No, 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 it's Watamu. Trust me, you will thank me later. Okay, so that is my countdown for Kenya. When you come to Kenya, come and visit. Come and do these wonderful things I've told you about. Feel free to reach out to me. I will help you plan your trip. I am at Nikki Faye the Wanderer. Follow me on Instagram at Nikki Faye the Wanderer. Thank you so much for joining me on my Instagram Live.